Yeah, I know most of you want to see more of this C10, so you can see I got a little rust on bottom of the door rocker. Bottom of the beds got some rust pits around the bottom of the windshield. Got some rust. There, got some rust. Got some rust there. Rust there. Some more bottom of the windshield. The rocker panel. Bottom of the bed. Looks like the back, around the back glass is okay, but I don't know till I get it out. I don't like it's beat up too bad. Got a good tailgate. Got all the parts in the rear. I think it's all of them, like both the fenders are in there, the hood, wheel wells. Got the custom tubular grill and the radiator. Core support. I got a good rear bumper and a bad front bumper. So I want to get all this stuff. First thing I would do, get all the stuff out of the bed and see what I got. It's kind of hard to tell, but you see the front of the frame horns are crooked. That one, you see that one especially, it's bent in and leaning over a little bit. This one's in a little bit, not much as bad as the other one, but. So I gotta straighten that out. But that's my setup right there. I already got the driver's side pulled back where it's supposed to be. So now I need to get on this side. So I got the frame straightened out, got the front cap stuck on with a couple bolts here and there just to hold it together. I like old school, probably gonna put like a 454 in it, cause I like a clean engine bay with not a bunch of wires and stuff running everywhere. It was just an engine bay and a nice looking big block Chevrolet motor sitting there with aluminum valve covers and a carburetor, high riser, all that cool stuff. That looked cool, I think. I like that. Nice clean looking under the hood. Probably TH400 transmission. It's got a 3-speed floor shift in it right now, but it's gonna have to be lowered, rear end flip kit and drop spindles on the front. Gonna have to lower it down. I got a big heavy duty strap. Alright guys, there you have it. Front cap is off, doors is off, the cab is off. So this is what the chassis looks like. You guys You guys have been beating me up about these wheels, so my neighbor's got some rally wheels, some C10 rally wheels, 15-inch, so probably gonna buy them from him. Probably somebody hooked a chain to that front, this frame horn this side, and tried to yank this thing sideways, trying to pull it out of a butthole or whatever. Anyway, that's probably what bent them front frame horns, yanking on it sideways, because I don't think it's wrecked. I think somebody just pulled on it. All the other evidence of bent cross members were they yanking on it, so that's probably what it is. So now we got to get the break the frame down, get the rear end out, and get all the front suspension off of it. Probably gonna need all new bushings on the front. They look pretty tired. All right, boys and girls, welcome back to Rat Rod Bob Builds, little shop where dreams come true. So we got the 78 C10, we got the cab, bed, doors, all that off of it, down to the chassis. So now we're gonna continue disassembling the chassis. So I can do whatever how you like it. All right, yeah. And one of you guys commented, hey, that'd be a good name for a truck, Junkyard Dog. You know what? I'm going with that. From henceforward, this is the Junkyard Dog build. 1978 C10, sharp bed, 454 big block, TH400, lower down. Yeah, bucket seats console. Junkyard Dog, there it is. You know, if I was Chip Foose, I'd draw a picture of my vision for this truck, but I'm not Chip Foose. I got the vision in my head. You guys just got to wait till it's done, is the only thing I can tell you. Like still twisted on that end. So Junkyard Dog, we're gonna call it, name it Junkyard Dog, and we'll call it a bare bones build for several reasons. One, we got it tore down almost to the bare bones, still got to tear this down, but most of it is bare bones. And when we get done, it's still gonna be bare bones because I wanna do AC and heater delete, power brake delete, and power steering. Delete. Front and rear bumper, delete. I want a clean engine bay. I don't want all that junk hanging off the firewall and all the accessories on the front of the motor. I don't want all that. I want a clean motor with nothing but an alternator hanging off of it and the firewall clean is what I want. Bare bones. Junkyard Dog, bare bones. That's what we're gonna have. That looks a little bit better, with emphasis on a little bit. 100% welded in. Yeah, frame looks pretty good. I mean, it's not perfect, but hey, it's a frame. And besides, I might have to do some more modifications to it. And but I got some touch-up paint. I can touch it up. I might have to do something about the shock mounts because, yeah. Well, flip that rear end, we got to deal with the shocks. So, yeah, that. Might have to clip these front frame horns when I do the front bumper delete and put a roll pan on the front. I had to clip those. But it's just satin black. I got spray cans of satin black. Just touch anything up I need to touch up. But hey, I think it come out all right. Not bad, not bad. Got a few rust pits in it, but hey, it's a frame. Who cares? Ain't nobody gonna see it. Yeah. Well, it might as well see a little bit up in front with the hood open, or if you crawl up underneath it. But I got it painted all up underneath everything, so yeah. It'll be all right. Got these bad boys painted too. So I reckon next thing I need to do is get that 10 bolt rear end up in here, get it disassembled as much as I need to see what I need to do to it. But hey guys, we're getting it. We just ain't got it yet. We need to put a limited slip carriage in here. So yeah. All right, I'm pull this axle out. Oops. I may be upgrading axles because that don't look good. There we go. Carrier is out. Yep. Come right out of there. There it is. I got a solution for this oil, let me show you. So I got all this dust, dirt that I swept up off the shop floor, keep it stockpiled there. And the reason why I do that is this. Right there. Yeah, that shop floor dirt. It's a valuable asset to the shop. No kitty litter needed. Yeah, I got the parts cleaned up a little bit better. I can deal with them better now. Yeah, pressure washer, steam cleaner. Yeah, nice to have that. And thanks to a good fan, I now have a cowl hood for the project. Of course, those of you in the know that don't fit a square body. It fits a generation after that. But hey, Rat Rod Bob loves to cut stuff up, so I'm gonna cut the skin off top of this hood and weld it on the top of the other hood. Yeah, I'm gonna take my old hood and fix it up, brace it up good, and all that good stuff. But I'm gonna weld this top skin. At least a cowl section on it. To have, I want a cowl hood, so there it is. Appreciate you, Daniel. So I chickened out on taking that bolt out. I just had to take about 10 thousandths out of that hole to make it fit. And then I took another piece of axle tube I had to make sure I got clearance from there to the bottom. That bolt, and yeah, do 1/4 inch clearance, as a matter of fact. So yeah, so now I can get my axle housing in here and set it up. I got the frame level.
So I got about 3 degrees angle there. I know you're supposed to have 4 or 5, but since I raised the rear end up about 5 inches, I think 5 would be too much. So I'm gonna leave it where it's at.
Getting some new parts in. I got my Eaton style carrier, limited slip, and some limited slip gear oil, crust sleeve for the pinion shaft, pinion seal, the bearings for the carrier, the repair bearings for the axles. I got 2 of those. Manual steering box, which the bolts don't quite line up to the frame, so I'm at frame rail, whatever you want to call it. But anyway, I'm at modify the frame rail a little bit for that to fit. Ball joints, control arm bushings, tie rod ends. Whole box of goodies for the control arm right there, front suspension. Yeah, we're getting stuff. Well, that was fun. Made a mess. That's just 2 of them. I got 2 more. That's 2 easy ones. That's the 2 easy ones, but I got them done. Bushings and ball joints. All I need to do now is get some black paint all over them, like they've done that chassis frame. Yeah, chassis parts. Yeah, I saved the best for last. These are big fun. Man, what a job. And I'm not even done with those yet. I still got to change the ball joints and man, that little clip you guys watched, well, for me, that was a whole day and into the night working on those control arms. So see if I can do this without getting dead. Got one of them. Oh, it's almost in there already. That's in. She's in. We're getting a whole lot closer to having a chassis instead of just a frame. I got the motor mounts in. I got the control arms in. So I got 2.5-inch drop spindles. They come in a few days ago. So this is where we're at now. I got the control arms on. I got my 2.5-inch drop spindles on. They just stuck on their finger tight. And because I need to do a lot of work on adjusting and all that on the front suspension. But what I done wasn't done. Using the shims on the top control arms, I got my spindles with a 4-degree caster. And using the flat, which is pretty much straight up and down on that spindle. And just a caster, and then I use this flat right here to get the camber. I got a 1-degree camber. You can't hardly tell with that, but I used my iPhone with a angle finder app, which gets a more precise measurement. That's what I use actually. But anyway, I got on both sides, I got like a 4-degree caster and a 1-degree camber, which is good enough to get me to the alignment shop. And hey, who knows? It may be good, may not even need to go to the alignment shop. Because once I get all this set up and get the toe end set, it'll probably drive good. Now I got my toe end tool in place. And naturally, when the front goes in, the back's gonna come out. So I only need to go ¼ inch total. So I need about 1/8 inch on each side. So turn this about 1/8 inch. Oh, by the way, this thing drives perfect down the road. I'm talking about you can let off the wheel and it keeps going straight down the road. I don't even have to bring it to a alignment shop. It drives perfect just like it is. It don't need no alignment. It's lined up perfect. So I don't have the coil springs in yet. The reason why is I want to be able to jack up the suspension up and down. You know, when I was checking that caster and camber, I jack it up and down like natural, going up and down, make sure it was good. So that's supposed to be a manual box for a C10 manual steering is what that's supposed to be. Brake rotors, no good. They done too thin, can't turn them. Calipers, probably needs new calipers, need new brake lines. So I need the works on I need new rotors with the bearings. I got sealed, but I probably need new bearings, seals, rotors, calipers, brake pads, brake lines, brake hoses, I mean, for the calipers, brake hoses. I'm gonna make my own brake lines. On the rear, so I said I had everything for the rear end, except I don't have the rear brake drums or brake shoes yet. So brake drums, same as the calipers, they can't be turned. They didn't wore down too much. So I need new brake drums, new brake shoes. I got the slave cylinders. They went with $24 for 2 new slave cylinders. But I got as far as the internals of the rear end, I got everything. I got some shorter shocks for the back. As my buddy Larry in Arizona, AKA Chevelle Ranch, said, what he used was the front shocks off of four-wheel drive independent front suspension, like a late 90s four-wheel drive. So yeah, I got some of them coming. They're a little bit longer than the shocks, front shocks on this one. And they're a lot shorter than the rear shocks that come off of this, which is what I need. So, but I'm still gonna have to probably make some brackets to make them work. But I got the rear shocks. I got shocks coming for the back, be here in a day or two, so I get working on that. So what you doing, Red?
Parts list, Bob. We need brakes. I'm about to make a run to the parts store.
Okay. Brake parts list, what we need?
Everything. We need everything.
Where's Red at? Oh, there he is. What are you doing now, Red?
Making a list for the rear brake parts, Bob.
What we need for that?
Everything.
So I got the rear shocks in. That's extended. It looks like that's gonna be all right. This I'm not gonna be able to use this stud up here anyway because it won't fit on that. So I'm gonna swap that out. I'm gonna do something different up there. But it looks like the extended length is gonna be close enough. So I need to get the rear end housing jacked up and see if it looks how it looks when it's compressed. Well, I got my rear end jacked up. Well, that's about where the pumpkin hits the bottom of the bed, so I guess I need a rubber bumper here. But anyway, I checked on the shocks. The compressed length is 10 and a half inches. And I got 13 and a half, so yeah, we good. So the extended length is good, and the compressed length is good. Oh, there's Red back from the parts store. So what you got, Red?
Everything. You ain't gonna like the bill, though.
Let me see that bill. Holy moly.
Huh, what you get the bill for those raised white letter tires I'm about to buy on eBay?
Let's see what Red got here. See, all new brake hoses, brake drums, brake spring, brake shoe spring kit. Boy, I'm glad he got that. Rotors, wheel bearings, brake pads. Oh, cool, he bought me a brake packing tool. Boy, I needed that. See, calipers with the hardware. Dang, brake shoes. Dang, Red, you got everything.
Yep, got everything, Bob.
So I got the rotor here. Take just a little dab of that grease, put where that seal rise back there, just because I can and I want to. See what we got. So I got a half roller. I was gonna build a rear end and have a full roller, but yeah. But anyway, I got all the front suspension done. Springs in, idle arm, pitman arm, manual steering box is on there. I put the old out tire on the front just to roll it a little bit. Since I got to order more parts for rear end, I decided to drag the old 454 I got up in here to see what, take it apart, see if I got something I can use. Okay, so I got the engine tore down. We're in together now. I mean, I thought I had everything, but the pinion seal I had wouldn't fit. So I had to go shopping for one that would fit. So yeah, we're gonna try to finish for putting her together. I think I'm going about the right way, put the bearing in, put the seal in. Then I put the pinion up in there and go from there. See, I got a piece of pipe same size as that seal, so. It's gonna get plenty of oil when I dump some in there. So I got the crush sleeve on there. Let's see if we can get it like this. I think that'll work. Sneak this in from the back side. Yoke. I would say y'all let me know if I'm screwing up, but it'd be time you see the video, it'd be too late. I got about 12 inch pound. I don't know if you can see that or not. Might be a little more, might be 13. I think it's gonna be good. I'm good. I got lucky to use one crush sleeve. There we go. All right. I think this side here is gonna be perfect though. Might be a little less than 10 now. Let's go one in there. So actually I do, after I put the dial indicator on it. I got 11 thousandths. I got the brake lines on. Yeah. And hey, we're getting it. We just ain't got it yet. Well, it's time to paint the rally wheels. But before I do, I gotta check the fit. Good thing I did. We got an interference problem right down on the bottom control arm. You can see on that wheel where it's rubbing there. Here. I gotta grind some off the bottom of that control arm. So it's a good thing I didn't go with 3-inch drop spindles. Cause I'd have to go with bigger than 15-inch wheels to go with 3-inch drop spindles. So yeah, but no problem. I can grind some off that bottom control arm. I didn't think that frame would twist that much, but it does without any weight on it. Yeah, that's what happens when you go over rough territory with your truck. So I got that done on one side. I took the cutoff wheel and cut this piece here back further. It was up here, I cut that back further. Done a lot of grinding all up in there. And I think you can see I got about 1/4 inch clearance now. So it should be good. It should not knock the wheel weights off. Oh, wait, whoa. Well, you done went done. Inspiration, Bo. Inspiration? That's clickbait right there, Red. I mean, yeah. Yeah, you getting popular on YouTube, so clickbait. Yeah, no, we're not gonna use the tunnel ram, Red. I don't think. I mean, well, who cares? The gas price of gas so high anyway. You ain't gonna be able to afford to drive it. Red done stuck the tunnel ram and the aluminum valve covers on it, headers. Man, this side here fits like socks on a rooster. So you really need to stick around and check out some of Rat Rod Bob's state-of-the-art, tried and true, get-her-done technique. Yep, beautiful day here in Southern Mississippi. Hey guys, look what I done went and done. Yeah, ain't this a lovely sight? Boy, I got a fine chassis though. Got that done. That's a good thing. Yep, true duals. All the way out the back. I'm gonna do some rust repairs on the cab, windshield. So that was a pretty simple operation. So I gotta shrink this lip some to get that curve. That's what it looks like from this side. Yeah, with the camera, it's gonna be hard to see all this, but you see what we got there. So I cut me a template out of the construction paper and cut that piece out, welded it in. I'm gonna put a tack right there. I'm gonna come on this end, put another tack. I had to weld over a lot. I had to do some more welding. Yeah, but you can see just that little bit of grinding that's starting to look like a C10 again. There we have that repair. Little body filler, and it'd be like factory. Get her done. Guys, I got the rocker panels done and the cab corners. Thank you. Y'all know me, I ain't scared to cut nothing. So yeah, transmission, disassembly. Hey, even a redneck can do it. So I'm gonna rebuild my TH400. Well, I don't even know if it needs rebuilding, but I'm gonna put a kit in anyway. All right, guys, we getting it. We just ain't got it yet. Hey guys, I got the rotating assembly together on a 454 to go on my C10. I mean, even a redneck can do it. So you can see now why I wanted the engine dark blue. I mean, it'd make more sense when I get the engine and the engine bay, get the truck built, it'll look cool, hopefully. Hey guys, I've been smearing some blue suede on my C10 truck cab. Stick around and check it out. You don't want to miss it. You just don't. Hit it. See, I got my wires for the fan back, temporary ignition, starter wire, see if it'll crank without touching the carburetor. Success.
Hey guys, the old junkyard dog truck is 98.999% done. Come check it out. Door panels done with the armrest, got them in, everything. Still got to do the shifter boot, but we kind of patched up the carpet there, make it, at least it's no glaring, gaping, obvious thing when you open a door. It's not perfect, but hey, who cares, it's a rat rod. Yeah, I got the carpet patched up on this side too. Still got some, like I said, I got the shifter boot and some more trim work to do on the inside, a little bit here and there, but we'll get it. Back end's done, exhaust tips are in. Man, it's looking good. Yep, windshield would be nice. We'll be right back.
junkyard dog gonna eat some tires.
All right, hang on now. I'm gonna do a burnout.
Okay.
Man, that thing looks good. Truck looks good going down the road.